Come to the edge, he said. No, we are afraid. Come to the edge, he said. No, we are afraid. Come to the edge. They came, he pushed them, and they flew. So for me, it's like all about trust and trusting yourself and trusting the process. And if you just keep choosing things and doing steps that you feel bring you closer to your goal, eventually, one day, everything will come together. Dito at Doon is like a quarantine love story or non-love story. It's about how do you find connection in a time when you're supposed to be isolated. So my character is Len, and I'm a teaching assistant na lockdown, work from home. Very vocal, lahat ng hinanaing niya nilalabas niya on social media, and super very millennial character who meets Kaloy, which is JC Santos, isang delivery driver, rider, and they meet through an inuman, which is something that all of us have resorted to in the past this lockdown. So it's about whether a relationship that starts online can last offline. Yeah, I think more than anything, these past few months, everyone has kind of resorted to social media, diba? To parang get their frustrations out and like get information. Parang it's been our new world since we were forced to stay at home. And the same has been for me. Every time I feel something and I can't contain it, I'll tweet it or Instagram. And it's also served as like a great support group for finding like-minded people or people who are concerned about the same issues as you are, or sharing information to people who may not have known that this is what's happening and this is what you can do. So yeah, very naging ganun nga ako these past few months. So we shot it in December in a bubble out of town in Tagaytay and Batangas. And actually, the shoot was really fun kasi ang saya kasama nung cast and nung crew and si Direk. Parang everybody really gelled together, and it was like a retreat kasi yung location namin walang signal, walang TV, walang anything. So parang kaming lahat lang talaga yung sama-sama and like helped each other through it. So it was really fun. And we're so lucky then kasi TBA was so careful about all the protocols. They were very strict about us being the only ones talaga there in that location and things like that. So we relatively felt very safe considering. And just thankful to have work kasi diba, a lot of shoots and plans stopped for people in the industry when the lockdown happened. And this was also the first shoot that I did since like March 2020. So I was really happy to like be with other people, actually be with other people. Yeah, I was so nervous and anxious kasi parang ilang buwan nga akong walang minememorize na lines or things like that. So as in my first 2 days on set, I feel like I was just warming up. And sinasabi ko nga kay Direk, hindi ko na alam. Or things like that. But what really helped was when JC got there, because I got there 2 days before him. So nung dumating siya, parang I was like, may ka-partner na ako. And he's really the best, as in sobrang generous niya, super saya kasama. And I really watched all his films before. So to be parang his partner this time, I felt like how he shows that energy on screen all the more to whoever he's working with in the scene. I've seen some people make it last. I think, yeah, it is possible. Especially if you have a common end goal that one day you guys are gonna actually be together, diba? But I think if someone really wants to make something work, then you can make it work.
Nakita niyo yung post ko kanina umaga. Yung post ko para sa mga nagre-reklamo dahil bored na sila sa bahay. Gaano kahirap bang pumirmi sa bahay? Napaka-arte.
Naisip mo ba na hindi pare-parehas yung epekto ng mga nangyayari sa mga tao? Na dun sa sinabi mong yun, posibleng minamaliit mo yung pinagdadaanan ng kausap mo?
Oo, totoo. Parang in the past few months din, napag-uusapan namin ng mga kaibigan ko na when we talk and when we read tweets of the people we follow on Twitter, parang pare-pareho kami ng iniisip. But when you look at the bigger picture and step back a little, like, and try to look at the whole country, sobrang magkakaiba, diba? Parang everything is so divided. So sometimes you really realize that maybe you're in an echo chamber and you're dismissing like everybody else's thoughts and yung pinanggagalingan nila. So for me, that line is a reminder to always take a step back and try to, as much as possible, not be judgmental. And na kailangan mo talagang lawakan yung pag-iisip mo. Kasi I really think it's very important for discourse and to talk about things. So for that to be successful, kailangan mo din talagang bukas at makinig ka sa pinanggagalingan ng mga tao na iba ang pananaw sa'yo.
Wala na tayong magagawa muna ngayon, di ba?
So, sa tingin mo, okay lang na walang gawin dahil wala naman akong magagawa? Bang alam mo?
Yeah, oh my gosh. Kasi ang sabi ni JC kasi sa eksena na yun, parang, okay lang yan, wala ka namang magagawa. Tapos yun yung response ni Len. And sa tingin ko, sobrang totoo yun. Parang ako, I always found it so annoying or all the more irritating when someone tells you na just leave it alone or hayaan mo na kasi there's nothing you can do. Because, paano na? I mean, what's gonna happen na if everybody just thinks that way and nobody does anything or says anything? So, I think it's really very important to be honest and to talk and to try and do any little thing to make yours or someone else's situation better. Because you never know, diba? Even just a simple conversation or a simple act, you don't know how far the effects of that will go. So, I hope like it's also a reminder to everyone that any little thing can go a long way. Super happy! Actually, it's funny because I was supposed to go to that film festival last year. As in, this time last year, I already had tickets, ganyan ganyan, because my other film was part of it naman, yung Babae at Baril. And then everything got canceled kasi nga parang that was the start of the lockdowns and the flights all getting canceled. So parang to be back there a year later is kind of surreal. And parang looking back at everything that's happened, parang oh my gosh. Tapos hindi ka pa rin makakapunta. Parang in that way, it's like kind of frustrating. But at the same time, I'm also grateful that we're still able to make movies, you know, kahit paano the industry is still trying to get back on its feet despite everything that's happened. So I guess patunay lang siya na, you know, you just have to keep going and keep creating and keep doing your thing and hopefully everything falls into place. The script. Parang the first basis talaga for anything is if you like the script, if the story is nice. And then next is, of course, the director and the people you'll work with. So I always look forward to working with new directors. I'm lucky to get to work with JP, who directed I'm Drunk, I Love You and Gaya sa Pelikula. And si Prime and si director Rayred of Babae. Parang there's so many really cool young directors who have their own like unique vision and spin on things. So yeah, and that's what always excites me. It's the story and the role and then the people that you'll get to work with on that project. Yeah, always. I guess it's just always been my basis for making decisions. Parang what really matters is the quality and not na parang kung ano-ano lang para lang, you know. So yeah, parang I always was hoping to build like a filmography that I'll be proud of, like when I'm older, and that I was able to do different things, not just one of the same thing all the time, and I got to work with different people. So parang yun talaga yung goal ko ever since, was to have a good like filmography that I can be proud of when I'm older. Mm-hmm. Yeah, pero parang natutukan ko lang talaga siya when the lockdown happened. Parang doon ko lang talaga siya natuloy-tuloy. And I can say that it's really one of the things that really helped me parang stay busy and parang stay connected during the lockdown. Kasi parang it became like my little community, and it was fun to like get to share videos with my family, with my parents, with my siblings. So medyo naging lifeline ko din talaga siya nung lockdown. Things are just easy. Parang I feel like I've been in like complicated relationships before. And when you're younger, parang you think na, oh my gosh, I have to fight for this, ganyan, ganyan. But then my mom always told me na parang it should be easy, it shouldn't have to be so hard. And then parang when we started going out, I was like, oh, okay. Ito pala yung sasabi ng mommy ko, like, pwede pala yun. Na parang, you know, parang everything just falls into place and nothing is forced. He is like a real parang traditional family guy. It's in parang he always put his mom first and his brothers, and they have such a good relationship. And me also and my family are very close, and he's also always been very nice to them and supportive. And like little things like going to my brother's basketball games or watching Harry Styles with my sister. Parang I guess we're very similar in how we always try to put our families first. Parang I just felt so secure na he's very encouraging, and parang walang limitations, walang like anything. And it's, I guess, a good booster or like a good thing to not have to worry about anyone else na parang kung anong iisipin nila, or like will this be okay with them. And I guess that also came from myself na rin, na parang it doesn't matter, like I have my priorities, and it just helps that you know that someone will always be there to support whatever decisions you make. I guess that you shouldn't settle or force anything, and that if you really put yourself first and your priorities first and your goals first, parang siguro that's when you'll also only make room for people in your life who support that and respect that. Ooh, actually, it's very exciting for me. I was scared of it before, but ang pinaka-idol ko kasi is Jane Fonda, and she's like 84 or something. And I read her book, and then she always talked about how getting older was so freeing for her, na parang with age came more strength and more confidence. So parang from that, I realized that there's really nothing to be scared of, and it actually gets more exciting as the years go by. Janine Gutierrez, and I'm on Metro.Style.